Hey, boys, hey, girl. Look what JB got here. Lobel's from New York. Got me a... I know just what it is. It is a USDA Choice Prime Aged Beef Brisket. About that dog. This a hunt right here, huh? Oh yeah, packed all up on ice. Lobel since 1840. Cool. Yum. We be smoking this dog up real soon. I know it's kind of low light in here, but I ain't had no counter space in the other room. Oh boy. Hey. Hey boys, hey girl. Too early in the morning. I got this Lobel's brisket right down here, and I'm fitting to put some fresh, just cracked some pepper and some kosher salt on it. And the Weber Smoky Mountains outside getting fired up right now. So let me give it a bath and then rub it down. Sometimes on brisket, I just like salt and pepper. And that's what I got, is some cracked pepper. This is Texas style, the way they do it down there, or over there, should I say, and kosher salt. And I sound funny because I just woke up. How about that? So rub that all over in that meat, and let's do the other side too. This is a prime brisket too. I think I said choice a minute ago, but this is prime meat. This is the real deal. And they trim it up and leave a little bit of fat on that other side. And they recommend that you cook that fat side up. And they ought to know. So. You can argue with them if you'd like. No, you don't have to let this rest at room temperature for no length of time. I just got to go check on the Weber. I actually put the chimney of charcoal into the Weber. Yeah, I guess it was... JB had a fell out with an attack of the dumbass. I guess it was because so early in the morning I ain't had no coffee yet. And it fired up the Weber, had all the bottom vents wide open, nice load of charcoal in it. It's a hot thing of chimney. Temperature wouldn't go above 200. Well, what the F, you know? Fooling around. Well, maybe it just ain't lit good. We had a big rain come through yesterday, real humid outside. Let it sit. And after 30 minutes, it's still sitting at 200. And something ain't right. Top vent closed. At least I didn't stay stupid. I found it. Now it's rocking. I had to go and cut all the bottom vents, just barely crack them. And we right at 245, or 235, I'm sorry. Lobel's. Says on their website to smoke their 9-pound brisket, which that's what that is, for 14 hours, low and slow. That's what they recommend. Okay? I got hickory on the smoker, too. They said if you really want to do a Texas style, use mesquite, but I got hickory. I don't have mesquite. I like hickory, too. I like mesquite on fajitas. It's real good on that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes chicken. Okay. Yeah, I didn't stay stupid though. Caught it. So our brisket is coming along beautifully. It's been smoking at 235 for clock for a while, about 9 hours now. And I'm getting ready to make a mac and cheese. And the recipe for that is very simply a quarter cup of butter, quarter cup of all-purpose flour, a couple pinches of salt, and you make up, you got to cook the flour and the butter and for about 5 minutes on medium heat, stirring constantly. Don't stop. So you're making a little blonde roux. Put you a couple pinches of nutmeg in there, salt, pepper to taste. You can use white pepper and it won't have no black flecks in the blonde roux. Then you add you a handful of your favorite cheese, boil your macaroni, put it in a casserole dish. I'll show it getting assembled. Okay? I've shown this so many times before. I really hate to show it again, but it's easy to do. Just like I just said, there's your recipe. Then top it with cheese, stick it in the oven, let the cheese melt, boom, eat. And it's super creamy, no eggs. Eggs make it like quiche. Quiche mac and cheese, fail. Okay, boy, pay attention now. Cammy did something funny there. All right, we got to get the Maverick probes in there. And I smoked my meat probes the other day. Well, I was sitting there holding 235, your dad a brisket. And don't put your top down on the damn concrete. I got some while it's open, so I can shut it back down because we're losing valuable time here. With the top off, you're wasting. Make sure it's got some resistance going in there, too. You don't want to leave the top off, boy. You know what I mean. Come on. Think this is barbecue central. Let's see, so probe two is the point. Probe one is the flat. It's at the plateau. It came to life. We leave it like that. It's at 160. Something like that. All right, so yeah, it's coming along. So there's that bad boy right there, fresh off the smoker, and it looks beautiful. Let's pull us a little piece. A yum, look like brisket jerky right there on the end. See in there? I'm gonna eat that. That other side. Oh, yum. I'll wrap it in foil and keep it warm. Let it rest. The flat was at 197. The point was at 195 when I pulled it and let it rest for about an hour. And it took a good, 12 hours, 11 and a half hours to smoke. Long-winded ass car. Yum. Excellent beer. I'm going to drink that whole bottle, and y'all see me laying on the floor. No, Junior JB going to help me out here, because I've been drinking. And he's going to have to do this. They had a brisket. And you wash all the cans up. Really good. Yeah. Is it hot?
It's hot, yeah, but it ain't that hot.
So we've got to see a, go ahead and cut.
I can see the whole belly twerking.
You see it? When I'm laying, like, lounge in the chair. You see it?
Let's see.
You can feel. It doesn't hurt. No.
Oh, shit, we still record. That's all right, good. All right, let's see here. Because this is the real test. Get you a piece. And see what they pull. See?
Pulled in my mouth.
Yeah.
Pull it. What happened? What's going on?
What happened? Good.
It is not working.
It's good.
Something smells.
That was JP.
I knew who it was.
They don't know you. Bradley here, a junior JB, had to help me open that bottle. That son of a bitch. That cork was tight. Yeah, so mix all your macaroni up with your blonde roux and evaporated milk, and then top it with cheese. And this prime brisket, I see the difference between a prime and a choice. It's in moisture, the tenderness and flavor. It's a big difference. This was fine. Yeah, here's your chart. See the canner and cutter grade? That's like Denny Moore beef stew. Yuck. So a big difference here, just like in a steak. These beans we got from LeBlanc's food store, and they're a lot like the Hunt's brand beans and fixins, Big John's beans and fixins. Really good. My daughter made me a Boston cream pie cake. It's the first time making it, and it was good. Thanks, girl. Fresh out of the damn can, and they was good, too. Last look. A yum. A boy. A girl. A bye.